So yeah, I'm hoping, I mean, mathematically we should make just over 700, which would mean we lost somewhere around, it made 853 before, so if we make just over 7, we lost somewhere around 150 horsepower going from the 6R80 to the Turbo 400. That's why knowing the combination when you're looking at dyno numbers is just so crucial, because you never know. I mean, this converter's a PTC, it's a coupled well, it's not going to slip much under couple, but it is a pretty loose converter. I didn't even look at what stall speed was that time actually, but it should be around 6500. So just keep that in mind when you're looking at dyno numbers, because this is literally the same tune-up minus the fuel changes I had to make. That it was on when it made 850 on 14.5 pounds with the lockup converter in it. So definitely interesting information there. So I'm gonna let it cool off, top the ice off, like I said, and we'll make one last hit with it here and see if we can break that 700 mark. All right, so real quick, before I show you guys the graph, to show you how much power change there was from the 6R to the Turbo 400. For you guys out there that are familiar with calculating horsepower from injector duty cycle, so this is a 0.75 lambda, 14.5 pounds of boost. It's got injector dynamics 1300s in it, and it is at 45 pounds of base pressure. I believe there's injectors are flowed at 43.5, so whatever, close enough. And it's 90% injector duty. If you're not familiar with doing that math, a rough online calculator would tell you it's around 1,000 flywheel. So yeah, all the differences in these two graphs is 100% just parasitic differences between the converter unlocked and locked and the different transmissions. I wouldn't say that the Turbo 400 is less efficient. This is a full roller, you know, Rossler close ratio, pretty gnarly 400. So I'm assuming it's fairly efficient, but I know the 6R is also extremely efficient in comparison. But the biggest difference here is definitely the converter, the unlocked versus locked deal. But yeah, check out these graphs. All right, that's it. That's what you made. 710, 610. That was exactly 14.5 pounds. The uncorrected numbers were 720. I don't remember the torque number. But just for reference here, I'm going to pull up my old 6R, the 6R80 dyno graph at the same boost level, so you can get an idea how much different the curves are. If you notice, this list is super long. You can see I've had a couple cars on the dyno of my own one time or another. Holy cow. So yeah, the last time I had this car on the dyno was actually 2019, which I think is kind of funny. But let's check that out. Alright, and the numbers. Alright, so check out the difference in the curve. You can see the car comes up fairly similar. Now, I don't know what RPM I was starting to pull at previously, I suppose. At what RPM I was rolling in the throttle. But just the shape of the curve is even quite a bit different, as you can see the converter working. So that's over. To give you an idea what the RPM graph looks like, to 7500, and there's the power number differences. So yeah, definitely interesting what swapping to a Turbo 400, you know, completely different style of transmission and converter will do. This is literally the exact same tune-up it had in it at that point. I had to pull a little bit of a fuel back out of it, because I had added some fuel later after I had tuned it, but the timing map and the fuel targets are all identical as it was for then. The only other difference is the hood exit on the car, which you would argue is probably worth a little bit of horsepower, if anything. Definitely didn't hurt it, but yeah, so definitely interesting. This is, it's again, all why you need to know when you're looking at dyno numbers. This is why we don't race dynos, because that's 150 wheel right there just in a transmission swap. So imagine if it was a stick. It'd probably dyno a lot like the 6R, I would assume. But yeah, so anyway, that's it for this thing today. I'm gonna get this thing out of here, back in the trailer, and head home and probably start working on research and putting the Haltech setup in it. So hope you guys liked it.